So good morning, girls. How are you all doing? You good? You good? So it's great here to come here today as we come together for our graduation. It's been a bit of a different, a strange year, hasn't it? Like, you know, it's been very strange. It's been kind of broken up. But we got there. We got through it all. And here we are at the end. So it's a good time for us to come together for your class and come together with the teachers and myself and Father Pat, chaplain for the school. Have we come together to look back over the last number of years you've been here? How many years in total now? Is this 8 years, is it? It's a long time, isn't it? Like, you know? You're a bit different now than when you came here first, I'd say, are you? You changed a small bit. But such is life. So it's great to come together to give thanks to God, give thanks and for everything in general. Give thanks for all that we learned, for all the people that we met. Give thanks for the teachers who taught us, for the people who looked after us. Give thanks for our parents and all that they've done for us, our brothers and sisters, and all the other activities we've had outside school as well. Give thanks to God for this opportunity of being able to grow and to learn and to grow in our talents and in our gifts and to appreciate how we're all part of a bigger picture, we're all part of a bigger team, and that God has a special role and talent for each one of us. This year, of course, we haven't had our confirmation yet. Our confirmation will be later in the summer, but we look forward to that, trusting that each of us has a special vocation and call in life. And we come here to pray today that we will always chase our dreams and try to do the best that we can, and that we can be all that we can be. So we turn out God with confidence. We ask that God would prepare our hearts to be open to the gift that he wants to give us this day in our Mass. And we acknowledge that sometimes we don't let our light shine. Sometimes we can cover our light, or we can not do what God wants us to do. But we ask God for forgiveness and pardon. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy. You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Your seat at the right hand of the Father did receive for us. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. So let us pray. O God, the Father of every gift, we confess that we have all that we have and all that we are comes from you. Teach us to recognize the effects of your care and to love you with a sincere heart and with all our strength. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. So now I'd like to invite Iris up to lead us in our first reading.
Sure that Jesus will always understand our troubles and that he will be a real friend to us. Dear friends, nothing could be better than knowing Jesus. I give up everything just to stay friends with him. Remember how much he suffered, and don't forget that we can always share our troubles with him when things go wrong. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
I'd like to invite up Aoife to lead us in our second reading.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Love is patient and kind. It is not jealous or conceited or proud. Love is not ill-mannered or selfish or irritable. Love does not keep a record of wrongs. Love is not happy with evil, but is happy with the truth. Love never gives up, and its faith, hope, and patience will never fail. This is the word of God.
Thanks. So please stand for the gospel. Reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Glory to you, O Lord. Jesus said to his disciples, "You are the light of the world. A city built on a hilltop cannot be hidden. No one lights a lamp to put it under a tub. They put on the lampstand where it shines for everyone in the house. In the same way, your light must shine in the sight of men, so that seeing your good works, you may give praise to your Father in heaven." The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. So you can sit down again. So we have our theme in our gospel today, that you are the light of the world. I thought it was quite a fitting theme for today, especially for presentation schools. What is the symbol we use for Nanonagel? Can you remember? The lantern, wasn't it? That she's to be known for going from house to house. You know, to help people in dark moments, to help people in times of trouble. And she became known for that. And we can see the lantern too as a symbol too of what's been handed on to us, isn't it? The light that's been given to us. The light of knowledge and the light of faith and the light of hope, and how we can hand on that light to other people too, can't we? You know, a candle doesn't lose anything by lighting another candle, does it? I want to show you a picture today. You might be able to see this down the back. Have you seen that picture before? You might have seen that picture, some of you. So in this picture, it's called The Light of the World. It's a picture from about 100 years ago. And in this picture, we can see Jesus, and he's there holding a lantern, the same as Nanonagel. So they saw him as the light of the world, that is bringing the light to there. And you can see he's out in a kind of a wood. It's a bit like St. Valentin's Well below. You can see all the trees around him. And you can see he's holding the lantern in his left hand, but then he knocks on the door with his right hand. And the man who painted this picture, his name is Volman Hunt. He was an English painter. And he was saying that this is a picture of Christ at midnight, holding a lantern in his left hand, and he's knocking on the door. And one person, when they were looking at his painting, they were trying to find a fault in it, and they said there's no handle on the door. And he said, no, he meant that because the handle is on the inside. So the door represents us, and it represents our soul. And that Jesus is knocking on the door of our hearts, asking, can we open the door from the inside to let his light in so we can share that light with other people. But it's quite an interesting painting in many ways. One of the things is the extent he went to paint this picture. He traveled to many places. He went through dangerous journeys. He took risks just so he could go to Israel, to the Holy Land, to see what the sky looked like there, so he could paint that in the picture, and for the other parts of the picture as well, that he really put his heart and his soul into this picture. Like all of you I know have put in so much work and effort in this last number of years into yourselves and into your learning and to be that light for the world. And the interesting thing is when he had finished his picture then, people thought it was so inspired that people wanted to see the picture all over the world. So the picture ended up being the most traveled picture in all of history. That is the picture that traveled most around the world for people to see. And so you can see he put a lot of traveling into doing the picture, a lot of work, and then the picture itself traveled a lot after that. The picture went to Canada and South Africa and Australia. They think in Australia that at least 3/4 of the people in Australia saw the picture at that time. Imagine that. It's a lot of it's a lot of people, isn't it? Like, you know? But it just shows you that the picture, called The Light of the World, proved to be a light to many people as well, a type of inspiration, something that really inspired them. And that's like us as well. St. Paul says that we're all God's work of art. I know you had Creative Week this year, where we looked at different types of creativity, how to come up with new ideas, how to look at things in a new way. And we oftentimes learn from our own art, our own creativity. And at the back of the room, of course, here we have this famous picture, which is probably painted by some of your parents, maybe. No? But that shows you too the power of art to inspire, to help us feel part of a bigger picture, and to be that light for the world as well. So we're all called to be that light. Give thanks to God for all that we've learned, asking him to give us the courage and confidence as we go from here. Maybe the world needs a bit more light in these days, doesn't it? It needs a bit more hope. And we ask that God would continue to help you to develop your talents and your gifts and to be that light the world needs at this time. So we're called to open the door to Jesus too, that he would give us his life, to continue to give his light to us as we prepare to for confirmation. We ask that we'd be able to fan into a flame the gift the Holy Spirit given to us, that we'd always keep it strong in our hearts. And we're called to be the light of the world. Of course, we don't use lanterns anymore, really, do we? Like, you know, maybe except for decoration. You know, you see them sometimes in gift shops and stuff because they look nice. But these days we use electric lights, don't we? We can just turn the switch and the light goes on. And Mother Teresa had a thought on this, that not only are we called to be the light of the world, but we're called to be like the electrical connections, you know, the thing that brings electricity that can be turned into light. Mother Teresa said, oftentimes we can see power lines running through the streetlights and along the streets, and this current is flowing, unless there is current flowing through them, there's no light. So if there's not any current flowing through the electrical cables on the streets all around town, there'll be no light. And Mother Teresa said, the power line is you and I. We're the connections. We're the people that connect, bring the connections to bring that power, that energy, that new life to people. And that we have the power to allow the current to flow through us and to generate the light of the world, Jesus. That we can allow Jesus to bring his light through us. And we can be the ones that can make that connections as we go from here. That we're connected to God and our faith. We're connected to our past, to our friends. And we may continue to make new friends and new connections and new ways of doing things. So we ask God to allow his power to flow to us, to be the best that we can be, to continue to develop the gifts and talents that we've learned so far, and to share them with all the world from here, that we can make new connections. We can be that light, and in the world of St. Francis, sorry, in the words of St. Francis, all the darkness of the world cannot extinguish the light of one candle. So never underestimate the power that your change can affect. So maybe now we stand again now, and I'd like to invite those leading us in the prayers of the faithful to come forward now, please. So we turn now to God, bringing out our needs and petitions, giving thanks to God for all that we are and for all that we've learned in our time here.
Sometimes we are too busy. We act as though work is the only important thing in our life. We feel guilty about stopping and resting. Let us ask God to help us
do
the summer holiday with
God. Lord, graciously hear.
We pray for our Pope, Pope Francis. We pray for our priest, Father Pat, and Canon Lini. May they always be guided by the Holy Spirit continually and continue to show God's love for his people.
Lord, hear us. Lord, graciously hear us.
We think of the beautiful things God has created on holiday. Seaside sand, sea, rivers, lakes, mountains, cliffs, hills, grass. May we look after the places we visit this year. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for peace, peace in all the troubled parts of the world, peace
peace in our own lives and in our homes. Help us, Lord, to work with you in building a more peaceful world.
Lord, hear us. How gracious to hear us.
We pray for the sick in our parish and for all who are lonely and unhappy, that they will receive comfort from their faith in God.
Lord, hear us. How gracious to hear us.
We pray for the souls of all the faithful parishes. May they rest in peace.
Lord, hear us. How gracious to hear us. As we end one journey together and begin a new journey, let us go forth into the world as people of faith, hope, and vision. Hold fast to what is good and render to no one any harm. Strengthen the faint-hearted, support the weak and vulnerable, help the afflicted, give dignity and respect to all. Love and serve the Lord Jesus, rejoicing in the power and guidance of the Holy Spirit. And we make these in all our prayers through Christ our Lord. Amen. So now we continue with our Mass. So now we'll have our offertory procession. If we can bring up our gifts now, please. So is somebody reading the... Okay, 1 second. So Elaine, I'll be there. I want to read our narration.
Seer shepherds of a flock, we share a time with others. Laura brings a football. Jade brings a picture of Shane to show that when we argue, we can become friends again. We offer Jesus our happiness. Grace brings some photographs for our friends. Photographs help us to remember our friends. We offer Jesus our praise. Chloe brings our steel crest. It is a symbol of how we we offer Jesus our whole soul. Lauren brings a candle. He reminds us that God is always with us. Keila brings a Bible. The Bible tells God's story. Maeve brings our artwork. We share our talents with one another. He reminds us of all the good times we have spent together gardening at school.
Brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice of my hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his church. From the gifts that you've given us, Lord, we offer you the sacrifice of praise, humbly begging that what you've conferred upon us in our time of learning here, we may give back to you to the glory of your name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. So please stand. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Father, mercies, and faithful God. If you have given us Jesus Christ, your Son, as our Lord and Redeemer, you always show compassion for children and for the poor, for the sick and for sinner, and became a neighbour to the oppressed and the afflicted. By word and deed, you announce to the world that you are our Father, and that you care for all your sons and daughters. So with all the angels and saints, we exalt and bless your name, and sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy and to be glorified, O God, who loved the human race and who has walked with us in the journey of life. Blessed indeed is your Son, present in our midst, when we are gathered by his love, and when as once for the disciples, so now for us, he opens the scriptures and breaks the bread. Therefore, Father most merciful, we ask you that you send forth your Holy Spirit to sanctify these gifts of bread and wine, that they may become the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, on the night of the Last Supper, he took bread and said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, once more giving thanks. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, to be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. My Lord and my God. So we say it together. My Lord and my God. Therefore, Holy Fathers, we celebrate the memorial of Christ, your Son, our Saviour, whom you led through his passion and death on the cross, to the glory of the resurrection, and whom you seated at your right hand. You proclaim the work of your love until he comes again. And we offer you the bread of life and the chalice of blessing. Look with favour on the oblation of your church, in which we show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ that has been handed on to us, and grant that by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted now and until the day of eternity among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion. Bring to your church, O Lord, perfect faith and charity, together with Francis our Pope and William our Bishop, with all bishops, priests and deacons, and the entire people you have made your own. Open our eyes to the needs of our brothers and sisters, inspire in us words and actions to comfort those who labour and are burdened. Make us serve them truly after the example of Christ and at his command. And may your church stand as a living witness to truth and freedom, to peace and justice, that all people may be raised up to a new hope. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the peace of Christ. So remember especially Ken and Tim O'Leary, who was a priest in Mitchestown and a priest in the school for many years, and Sister Anne Hurley, who a presentation sister who taught in the school for many years also, who died this year. Remember them and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your face, and in the resurrection give them the fullness of life. Grant also to us in our earthly pilgrimage is done, and we may come to an eternal dwelling and live with you forever, in a communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, and Blessed Joseph, our spouse, with the apostles and martyrs, with Saint Fanahan, and with all the saints. We shall praise and exalt you to Jesus Christ, your Son. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honour is yours, forever and ever. Amen. Amen. So we pray together the words that Jesus taught his disciples, as we say it together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from all evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we wait the blessed hope in the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. So you can sit down now. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof. When you say the word, my soul shall be healed. Just for communion, maybe if you just on the side, if you remain seated for the moment, and if the girls on the side, if you come up one by one first, would that be okay?
I
O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine. Come to me, all you labored and are burdened, and I will refresh you, says the Lord. O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine. So please stand. O God, who gave us a spiritual food, the saving sacrament of your Son, which we have offered here in thanksgiving, grant that by strengthened by gifts of courage and faith and joy, we may serve you and be worthy of still further blessings through Christ our Lord. Amen. So just be seated again now, please, and I'd like to invite those who are leading us in our reflections after communion. So I think it's Yvonne and Breed. Okay.
This is a summer prayer for you. Take it with you and keep it in your mind and heart. As you leave school for the summer, as you lay aside textbooks and notebooks and pencils and pens, go with God, for God goes with you. As you begin new projects or a summer camp, as you meet and make new friends, go with God, for God will guide you.
As you make a choice about places to go or about who to go with, don't compromise your values and go with God, for God knows your values. As you enjoy the summer sun and the summer's cool blue waters, be wise and safe. Respect the beauty of the earth as God's gift to you, and go with God, for God has created you. As you go to quiet places to reflect and pray, to enjoy the peace and the beauty of private space and time off, go with God, for God is always goes with you.
And could I invite Amy forward now, please, just for the crayon box that talked.
The crayon box that talked by Shane Deroff. While walking in a toy store the day before today, I overheard a crayon box with many things to say. I don't like red, said yellow, and green, said nor do I. But no one here likes orange, but no one knows quite why. We are a box of crayons that really doesn't get along, said blue to all the others. Something must be wrong. Well, I bought that box of crayons and took them home with me. I laid out all the crayons so the crayons could all see. They watched me as I coloured with red and blue and green, and black and white and orange and every colour in between. They watched as green became the grass and blue became the sky. The yellow sun was shining bright on white clouds drifting by. Colours changing as they touched, becoming something new. They watched me as I coloured, they watched me till I was true. And when I'd finished, I began to walk away. And as I did, the crayon box had something more to say. I do like red, said yellow, and green said, so do I. And blue, you are terrific, so high up in the sky. We are a box of crayons, each of us unique. But when we get together, the picture is complete.
So that's great now, so thanks for all that, like, you know. Thanks for everybody who helped in any way with our mass today, those who did readings and those who helped in any way. Thanks to our musicians again, excellent as always, and thanks to the teachers and to Mr. McCarthy for having me here today. So it's good to come together that we were all part, to learn that we're all part of that bigger picture. You'll always be part of the family that's here. But we go forward now to make new connections and to bring the values and the good things that we learned here and to help spread them with everybody we'll meet through life. I'm asking God's blessing on you as you begin, as we finish our time here and we begin a new journey together into the wider community. So if you just stand now, so just give you the final blessing. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. You sit down again. I invite Mr. McCarthy now for his.
I just want to say a couple of words on behalf of our school. First of all, I want to thank Father Donoghue there for that beautiful mass. I think you put a huge amount of effort and work into preparing it. I think there's some really important messages right throughout. And these are messages that your teachers, that our teachers and staff would have taught you over the years. And I think it's very important that you carry those forward with you. Special thanks, of course, to Mr. Dwyer and Ms. Walsh for preparing the mass and for preparing you all year. It's been a very difficult year and a half. to Mr. Wallace and Miss Watson again for adding to our ceremony, making it so special. I know Mr. Wallace is a sore hand at the spot of there. So thank you to both of you for performing here today and making this such a special day. I know later on we're in for a few lovely treats. I won't mention any in case I'm spoiling any surprise or whatever. But I know that there's some fantastic videos, and I want to thank Mr. Deneen. He was busy doing certs and videos last night, and of course Miss Watson. It's tradition at this stage, and Miss Watson has a beautiful presentation of photographs of you when you started here in school, so we're really looking forward to that. I want to thank all members of staff, because some of you have been here 8 years and some of you here 3 months, but all of you have worked with other members of staff, and I think you should feel very fortunate to have had your education in Bunscombe and Turbiton. We have, as you know, many, many fantastic members of staff that have worked really hard to bring you to where you are today. You're all Bunscombe girls, as I said, even those of you that have come later on here, and I hope you're proud of that, for the simple reason we're proud to say that you are a Bunscombe girl, and I know that means a lot. There's a long tradition here in Bunscombe of magnificent classes that have passed through in Bunscombe girls indeed. Today is all about just saying thank you to you girls. It's your day. That's what this is about. It's just to say thank you to everything that you've done in our school. And every single one of you, and it's really important you hear what I'm going to say to you, every one of you have made Bunscombe a better and a brighter place by being here. You've all brought something really good to our school. The last year and a half has been really difficult, but I think it brought out the best in a lot of us, and we had to be more thoughtful. We got to spend more time with our families and so on. You're a very talented group of girls. Sometimes we don't realise that. I mean, we have musicians, hurlers, camogie players, I should be saying, rugby, soccer, debating. We've dancers, we've seen you outside at lunchtime, fantastic dancing, singing, music, chess, artists, designers. I know a lot of you are looking to be architects. We've even dirt bike champions. So, I mean, there's a huge diversity there among you. And my wish for you is that you use your talents and don't forget them, and make sure that you make the most of them. I know sometimes this time of year can be a little bit sad, and that's a good thing, because that means you've enjoyed your time here. But, you know, I'm looking forward to, with great excitement for you all, as you move on to your new school. And it's important that you know that you'll always be very welcome to return back to Bunscombe. And I know that the staff here really, really enjoy seeing pupils coming back and telling us how they're getting on in secondary school. So we look forward to that. I've often said to you, and I'd say it to you again, it's the pupils in the school that play the biggest role in making a school a very good school. And I can honestly say that our sixth class this year, you're exceptional. As a group, you've been absolutely fantastic and great role models. And success particularly set the tone in a school. And I want to thank you for all that you've done. You've been outstanding. Your kindness, your hard working, and your manners. And instead of maybe going on, I just came across this little, I suppose you'd call it a poem. I think it says exactly, it's a little message in you, in it for you all in the future. And the title of it is, All I Need to Know About Life I Learned from My Dog. Okay, bear with me. And this is how it goes. Allow the experience of fresh air and the wind in your face to be pure excitement. When loved ones come home, always run to greet them. Run and play daily. Be loyal. Never pretend to be something you're not. And I've got this part. Eat with gusto and enthusiasm. If what you like is buried, dig until you get it. When someone is having a bad day, be silent. Sit close and be gentle. Thrive on affection. Enjoy the pats on your back. When you leave your yard, make it an adventure. Avoid biting when a simple growl will do. No matter how often you're scolded, don't pout or give out. Run back to the person and make friends. Bond with your pack, or in this case, our bowl. On cold nights, curl up in front of a crackling fire. When you're excited, speak up, let everybody know. When you're happy, dance around and wag your entire body. Delight with the simple joy of a long walk. And remember, if you stare long enough at somebody, eventually you'll get what you want. Don't go out without ID. Leave room in your schedule for a good nap. Always give people a friendly greeting. Don't hold grudges. Enjoy the journey. And finally, drink lots of water. Maybe Cristiano Ronaldo would have that one there. So I suppose really, girls, you know, we can't learn from dogs. And I suppose the one thing about dogs is they're very forgiving and loving and all of those things. And I suppose that's what we'd like for all of you. I, on behalf of our staff, you are an absolutely exceptional class. On behalf of our staff, okay, because I'm only here 2 years, and some of you have worked very closely with teachers for 8 years, but I'm the one that's speaking to you. On behalf of all of our staff, I wish you the very, very best of luck in the adventure that lies ahead. You're a fantastic group of girls. You're very, very talented. Make the most of them, okay? And thank you so much. We have a lovely day planned ahead. Thank you all so much, and well done, okay? Thank you.
Please stand now for our final song.